What's happening, YouTube? Paz here. So today I want to showcase what my living room looks like and the equipment that I've got installed to really give you this simplistic design that I wanted to go for. So I've got a floating shelf, which I've got from Wayfair. My wife got it. And as you can see, it really brings out a nice vibrant look and feel. And it matches my doors, as you can see on the left-hand side as well. So what I have as part of this setup, I've got this LG CX55 inch. Now I opted for this one because it has 120 hertz and is compatible with the Xbox Series X, and it's compatible with the PS5. So as you can see, you've got the Xbox Series X here, all plugged in. I've got the PlayStation 5 as well, all plugged in. So I've got an Ethernet cable going into the back. I've got a 8K HDMI cable going in, HDMI 2.1 for you tech geezers out there and tech ladies out there. And I've got the same going into the Xbox Series X. So I've got HDMI 2.1, power supply, Ethernet. And I'll show you how this all fits together. So with the TV itself, I had this wall mounted, and I'll show you what this looks like a bit later into the video, using a SONOS mount, so it fits perfectly against the wall. There is about, let's say, a 3-inch gap. And I could have really opted for the LG GX for that, but I didn't really want to spend that extra bit of money. It wasn't really worth it because it's the same panel. Here, as the main soundbar, I do have the SONOS play bar. And this SONOS play bar I've had for over 6 or 7 years now. And that's a 5.1 surround. So I've got the SONOS play bar there. Again, that's connected to the Wi-Fi. And then I have two rear pointing play ones to give that 5.1 with an additional subwoofer that came with SONOS as well. I did have this previously mounted to the wall, but I wanted it to rest on the floating shelf just to give it that extra bit of appeal. Otherwise, it would have looked too busy just below the TV. Now what I've done to actually give this a nice clean finish is to actually embed the, let's say, all the cabling, all the HDMI behind the wall. So I actually broke off a piece of the wall here, put some insulation in, put all the cables into this, let's say, plastic frame, and just fed the wire through there to really give that nice clean look and feel. Now, I also have my Skybox connected, as you can see here. And what I've done, and I'll give you a zoom in later into the video, is hide all the cabling and power supplies into this section here as well. I also have, let me just bring it forward, the Nintendo Switch that's again connected via HDMI and power as well. So I'll show you what this looks like further into the video as we get a close up in. And then I've done the same here, so really hide all the internet, all the Ethernet cables directly into the shelf below to really give you this seamless experience. Now behind the TV, again, I'll show you this later in the video, I've actually connected some modern lights. So I got some lights from Amazon. They're from Govee, check those out. They're not too bad. It does give you the look and feel and the appeal that you need. But they're just not as bright as I expected them to be. Hey guys, time for that zoom in now. So let's take a look. So I've got the lights on, as you can see. I have plugged these in all the way around. So I got these Govee lights, like I suggested. They were for a 40 to a 60 inch TV. And you can see how I've positioned those. So they're hidden. They're connected to the USB socket as well of the TV. So make sure you get that so you don't see any additional wires. And I've got the control center here, so I can actually turn the lights on off from here. I can turn the lights back on from here. I can also switch between different moods as well. So I can switch to different lights here. As you can see, they're changing color as we go yellow, red, green, lime, blue. I like to have it as a cool, is it soft white or warm white in the nighttime, because you can't really see these in the daytime. Now, if we look here, so I just need to finish off the paint job here. That's why the masking tape is there. But all I've done is brought in the wires from the back of the unit to showcase here. So you can't really see that from the front. Same with the Sonos, so it's hidden here. And if we take a look at the back of the Xbox Series X, I've done the same here as well. So that's pretty cool. In terms of the PlayStation 5, it is a bit of a behemoth. So I didn't really want to stand that up. So I wanted it enclosed in here. But as you can see, all the wires are coming through the back there, just to connect everything together. And here, as promised, I've actually broken in the cabinet just to get access to the power supply. So I've got one, let's say, power socket feeding this extension here, and I've just stuck in all the garbage and all the power cables that I needed here to create that seamless finish. I hope this was good. I hope this was appealing. If you're looking to do the same thing, please let me know. I'll be happy to help in the comments. If you do enjoy the channel, and if you have enjoyed this video, please do help the channel by hitting the thumbs up button and by subscribing to the channel. Thank you very much, guys, and take care. Bye-bye.